Going to Mars is not Star Trek. It's not go where no man has gone before, as they say. It's really all about letting our planetary scientists be the pioneers, be the group that scouts the future and looks at resources that we can use on the planet. What are the things they need to know to be able to safely land, live, and return from Mars? The scientific knowledge, the technologies that we need that can make human exploration of Mars happen are within our grasp. In our lifetime, we actually can see humans land and work on Mars. A major step in this direction of planning has been the definition of what we call human exploration zones. This is a region we will land, we will live, we will use resources in many different ways, and we want to go to a variety of scientifically exciting locations. Do it in ways that humans and only humans can do. And so our orbital assets are critical to be able to determine and look for those right landing sites. In addition to that, you may not know that they are also relay satellites. These relay satellites are critical to support our landed assets. Our communication will also increase significantly from typically the radio frequencies that we use today to perhaps optical communication. That'll be a critical communication technology that will allow high bandwidth data, voice, but also video, so necessary to support human exploration on the surface of Mars. There's a variety of in-situ resource utilization experiments that are being thought about and planned. These are important to understand the area of our landing sites. Power systems and energy systems will be deployed that are very new and unique. Supply of oxygen and carbon in the atmosphere is how we can extract oxygen in the quantities, but also sufficient water. We now know there are regions on Mars for which there may be an abundant source of water. So these observations that we are making are revolutionizing our concepts of how we're going to use the resources to live and work on Mars. So, why are we going to Mars? Well, because as scientists, it's really a step in terms of finding life beyond Earth. You know, exploration is really in our genes. It's a very integral part of what we are all about as humans. But as a human species, if we're going to survive, we need to move off this planet and onto the next object. And Mars indeed is that next object. So Mars gives us a wonderful opportunity to explore scientifically today. But in our future, it is a location where we can go, we can live, work, in addition to return.